Mefor originated from. You see what makes you a true freedom fighter. You know, a lot of people have encountered people whom I trusted their credibility and their declaration and even the oath taking that they are true freedom fighters. But as time progresses, I discovered that some of us, I have to be honest, are not what we think they are. They are not true freedom fighters. Let me say who a true freedom fighter is. You see, our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, I will never in 1 million years or billion years doubt his credibility. I will never. Partly when I came to United Kingdom newly, I did risk management and creative industry in one of the universities here. In the first semester we were undertaking, we were taught what they call pestle analysis. You use that pestle analysis, a simple political, environmental, you know, economy and of a place to set up a business. If you do the analysis, if that place is not conducive, if that pestle analysis didn't give you go ahead, banks use it today. That's why they ask you for business plan. So they will X-ray what you have documented. If they are not convinced, they will not give you loan. So I have our own freedom fighting pestle analysis to know who is a true freedom fighter. So a true freedom fighter is someone that can go against every odd, against every status quo. Take a look of our leader and see. When he began, he has to pay bills. A lot of people don't know what bills is all about in Europe or Western world. You don't get anything for free. It's not like here. I mean, it's not like in Africa where you just go at the back of your compound and pluck, or in front of your compound and pluck orange or banana or mango, and that can hold you for a while you are trying to struggle to get money to get some, you know, nice meal or hot meal. You can hold yourself, but in the part of the world where some of us are, you don't get anything for, I like using South African language, for mahala. For mahala, for sa, you don't get it. You pay for anything that you use. Actually, you in the Netherlands, you pay for the environment. You pay tax for your air, the air you breathe. They call it milieubelasting, environmental tax. You pay for it. So our leader, having set up the radio platform, it takes a lot of money. I think at that time he said he was broadcasting on shortwave, and it takes a lot of money. So he had a, you know, a company, and he's working. And when you do in economies, like when he was talking about when he was doing his last broadcast, he made mention of drawing scale of preference. I studied economics, so I know if you draw a scale of preference, there are many things that you want, but there are other things that you need. You have to choose the most pressing need, and the other ones will be alternative for God. You keep them away. You don't need them, but you want them. So you can't take them. You take the one you need. So our leader, for him, the radio platform is his priority. So he set up the radio platform to do broadcast rather than paying for his house. Are you getting me? Paying for his house, he paid for the radio to save us, to inform us, so that we cannot be destroyed. And he sacrificed his comfortability, his comfort zone, in order to have the radio platform that we are even speaking through and listening to set it up. This is a true freedom fighter. Not only that, he left. He was sleeping in his car. If you don't know how Europe like during winter, I don't know the season, but it could be winter. It is not an ideal thing. it is a very big risk to sleep in your car because you can be frozen. As I'm speaking right now, it is snowing all over Europe. It is snowing. Your car is buried. Every car is buried with snow. It's white. I had a meeting with somebody in Canada yesterday. The Canadian snow is like, the thing is like, it's like mountain. You won't see where your car is parked. You can only use your gimmicks, like, you know, as a human being, or I parked at this position, this should be my car. If not, you will never discover which car is yours. If you are the drinking type, those that drinks, when they park their car in the east, when they wake up, they will be going to the west, saying, I parked my car at the west. And someone will remind you, oh, mister, I saw you walking from the east last night. That is where you parked your car. It's not stolen. So this is what we experience. This man, we forget everything or forgot every other thing. His family and the bills. And he will be paying for this platform. Now, Ushemefo, he will drive Ushemefo to his apartment. I know where this man lives. He will drive him there. And after when he has gotten up, that is to show you that Ushemefo is not a spiritual man. If Ushemefo had been in the spirit, Elohim would have told him about his partner. Let me put it that way. His boss, who is sleeping in his car. He because he's not a man of the spirit. I will go a little bit on Ushemefo when I have cleared this thing that Mazi and I was talking about last time. If Ushemefo, Mazi Ushemefo, is a man of the spirit, at the first encounter, the spirit of Elohim would have told Ushemefo that, look, your brother is homeless because of this. Regardless of what, you can clear the lounge, or you and your wife can come to the lounge, and while your boss goes to the bedroom. I have been into a business partner's place. I traveled to one country to buy some product, and the man who invited me saw when I came. He said, it's not ideal thing for you to go and stay in a hotel while we have a beautiful home. My kids have their rooms. You know what? I and my wife will vacate the bedroom for you. So he remodeled, he kind of, you know, made the bedroom over, made it over, makeover. And eventually I went in his bedroom for that week that I spent. And I was making sure that the wife doesn't go to the kitchen during the time I was there. I said, do not go to the kitchen. We will be going to restaurant to have breakfast with the kids. So I used to use that opportunity to support them rather than occupying the bedroom and still keeping the woman busy all the time. So she kind of said, each time if I don't show up, she will push the husband, say, call him, ask him when he's coming, because anytime he comes here, I don't go to the kitchen, you see to that. So you Ushemefo isn't a kind of guy that is connected in the spirit. And I'm not surprised for what is going on. So our leader will forfeit everything, and was using the money to pay for the radio while sleeping in the car. Can you imagine that? And nobody knows. I have done it. I have done this sleeping in a car. Not that I was homeless. I had a home, but there is a certain country that I challenged. So when I challenged that country, I took them to court. It's a Western country, superpower. I took them to court. So they were now sending their secret agent to come and eliminate me in my house. I got the notification. I started sleeping in the car. I was paying for the place, but I was sleeping in the car. I don't stay there at night. So I will move my car in different locations. When it was winter, heaven knows, this thing lasted for 13 good months. I was paying for my place, but I wasn't sleeping in my house. So I know what it is. I know exactly. I almost contracted pneumonia. As a matter of fact, I contracted it, but Elohim, with the medical team, cured it. They didn't know. Sometimes you can even get choked in the car while you let the heater run. You can get choked. If you let the engine run and you slip off, you can die from there. A lot of risk that is attached to that. I went through it for 13 good months. So I know exactly what that man went through. I know what he went through. Not that I wasn't capable of keeping a home. It was registered. I sue a country in Europe to court for violating my rights. And so many other people, the Africans, they're killing. I challenge them. That is the reason why I am in the location where I am today. Because they were saying that it is a very big embarrassment with evidence that I took them to that level and embarrassed them. And that's exactly what made me to be very, very in this freedom fighting to make sure that we get our nation. There is nothing like having your nation. You can't amount money. There is no money. This is the reason why I am so like passionate about what I'm doing. But let me go back again to this particular issue of sleeping in a car. And Ushemefo is living in a house comfortably. Our leader did not inconvenience him. Our leader did not ask him, may I just pass 1 week? Spend a week in your house. This is the situation. He did not communicate to him to that level. So you can understand whom your leader is, whom our leader is, because of those running their mouths. He didn't share anything with him, no information. They don't know what is happening. And you think because you don't have information, you can now go and start blackmailing somebody and destroying what Elohim has set up himself and using our leader. You see, there is something Mazi Anayo said. I want to paraphrase on that. He said, any day he sees Uchemepo, he will not let him go scot-free. It is not only Mazi Anayo from Finland that had that or is having this much notion in his mind. So many of us, it is clear that we can understand him. He declared his stand from day one. A true freedom fighter, we never look at you from the tribalistic point of view or from family point of view. Do you know, as I'm saying it clearly, I have already passed the message to anyone that I related with or to. If you are standing against me in this restoration project, and you said you cannot allow me to do what Elohim wants to do, as a matter of fact, you are next to go down before Nigeria. I will take you down straight away. This man, Uchemefo, did, and I'm not saying for some people, it is a distraction. But some of us who knows what is going on, we can tell you what this guy, the depth of evil this man is with his team, Obidi Obieno, and those that their names appeared in the list that plotted this coup. Uchemefo plotted this coup, this very particular thing we are seeing for a very long time since our leader was in jail. Uchemefo had this thing in his mind that he can get rid of our leader to take over. And not everybody can do what Mazi Anayo is doing. Regardless of whatever, I have to be honest. He came up very hard and harsh. I spoke on this platform last time, and somebody quickly called me. And this person it's good that I talk about this. It's good that I talk about the politics, the government and this. But on the other one, don't even say it. Don't go there. I said, in my mind, I told him, actually, I hung up the phone. I told him, you don't call this number again. I said, in my mind, I wrote you a song. You know, they always say, how great you are. How great you are. Then I wrote a song saying, how dumb you are. How dumb you are. Very, very dumb and foolish. Because you have somebody who is from your village. And you know that thing was going against that person for what he's doing in the struggle. For the damage the individual is doing in the struggle. And all of a sudden I made a statement. I came on air. I said something. No name was called. You quickly called me because it's here. It's your town man and your village man, you fool. If If you are in front of me, I am armed. I will take you down. I tell you before, I will take you down. I will take you down immediately and go for anyone that is related to you, because it is a venom that they gave you. This Ananias, a man, came up to, no one can do what that man is doing. He, regardless of the fact that they are from the same village, probably from the same tribe or so, but he done those things and came up and said, no, I distance myself from this man. I can't let this man do get away with this nonsense. Some people will come up and say, after all, I'm from Idemili, and let me go and back him up. Therefore, restoration project program has become tribal thing, has become Idemili thing, when it is not. It is all about Biafra and about our which MFR, under my understanding, I can tell anyone listening to me, this is not the first time I'm involved in a freedom fighting movement. I think I don't know what Elohim is doing with my life. I ask him the other time, when will I get rest? When will I ever get rest? I don't understand when I see somebody, my fellow human being or black man, being executed or put in a death camp, death row. I don't understand that. So whenever you see me talking, I am talking from personal experience. Nobody knows the nation that I took to court in Europe, and they got mad, their superpower. I told them, I will drag you down. You can't do, they've killed a lot of black people there. And some people are talking from that nation, but they don't know what they're doing. To Africans, most especially. I can link them, I say, why should you be doing this? I didn't care that I have, they gave me nationality. Damn it. Damn the nationality. For my freedom. Damn it. I said no. And they said they will kill me. The attempted assassination, I escaped it. That's why I'm like this. So what can you give me to abandon what I am fighting for? Mazia Nayo could have said, he have one name, okay? Come back to damn it, he said no and came up. I hear some people talking because some one individual came on air and said, oh, somebody did that, and I came on air. I said, do not crucify the young man. This nonsense has to stop. This nonsense, for the fact, do you know, let me say this on air. For those of us that have taken photograph with our leader, I want to warn you. If you use that photograph to go and launch some certain things and said, I'm very close to our leader 5 and 6. If you are caught, you will be dealt with sooner or later. Do you know why bodyguards follows most of the presidents? They won't allow you to take photograph with him, because you might use that photograph to do some damages. And some people who say they are freedom fighters did not understand this level we am taking them to. I have been into security service for a very long time, so I know what I'm talking about. When we want to go for operation, we get briefing. We get briefed on what to do. So I will not allow you to take photograph with, if I am covering a president or one of the diplomats, I will not allow you. If I will do that decision, he can't tell me. I will not allow you to take photograph unless in a conference where groups are taking photo, diplomats or presidentials are taking photograph. Then we will step aside. Then you will do that. But if he's going to somewhere here and there and you just come and say, let me, sometimes it can be allowed. Yes, but not all the time, because you can use that thing to go and do some damages. Likewise, some of the people that have appeared at the background of our leaders, activities, and they have photograph, and they use that photograph to do some certain things. Or some people, they come online all the time and use that privilege. They say, I am connected with this DOS. This DOS is my 5 and 6, I know him. We talk all the time. And because of that, he use that opportunity to go and do destruction. And well, unfortunately, when you bring it up, they say, this is outside the movement. No, this is within the movement. It is within, let me tell us, I said it last time. Mazobilo, did you see the picture that you, on your WhatsApp?
Yes, I did.
The very young man you saw in that photograph, who had flag on his head, was the one that ushered Madiba in when he was being inaugurated as the first black president of South Africa. That young man, when that inauguration was over, 2 weeks later, the man was caught in a camera in a robbery scene. That guy vanished from that. He went to jail and never, no one has heard of him till this very day. The question is that what they said, for him to appear in such a very prestigious platform, what could make him to go into crime scene, committing crime? If it is not dealt with, it can affect the leader. A lot of people think this is my friend's, oh Lord, if I know that some of our people can think like this, I would not have undertaken what I have undertaken. Because I know whenever I come on air and I'm saying something, I'm saying it on experience, not theoretical experience. From personal experience, I'm talking. And also professional experience, knowledge that I have. So if you appeared on some certain scene or being on the radio all the time and you get it down, you be give a call to people vulnerable back home. They will say, this is a principal officer. This man is always doing this. He's always doing that. So anything, if you tell them to give me this, they will give you. They are doing it because of the IPOB platform. Outside the IPOB, they don't know you. That is what led this man into all these gimmicks and scams. It is under IPOB. Where do I know you from? From IPOB. I don't know you from Adam. So if you tell me to stand as a comrade, I will stand. If you tell me to run as a comrade, I will run. But no, some of our people, even to those that have positions, high positions, doesn't want to reason. I have nothing to lose. I tell every Biafran listening to me, I have nothing to lose. If I have swum a Mediterranean sea and ocean, what is a pond? This is not a river. What is a pond? Why should I be afraid to say the truth? Our leader founded the movement on whiter than white and whiter than snow, transparency. That doesn't mean that you have to be flippant and you don't have secret of operation. Secret of operation is different from transparency. That you can, your colleagues can read you at all time and read you accurately. That is what it is. Your movement can be read and be read accurately. Not during the day, Biafra freedom fighting, at night, telephone calls back to Biafra land and be deceiving people. That's what we're talking about. If ANC can do that to that man, and we are saying that we are whiter than white and whiter than snow, we should be very careful. If you tell me to do anything out of this platform, if Mazobilo could call me and tell me any report, I will never doubt him. Because we took an oath to salvage or to deliver our country, to fight for our liberation. I will never suspect Mazobilo that he's telling me inaccurate or giving me inaccurate information. I will believe him. He's my comrade. The thing is, beyond the radio platform, it is within our activities, how we conduct our activities. If I appear in a crime scene here, my penalty will be heavier than civilians. Because I know the law. Even when you are ignorant of the law, they will tell you that it's never an excuse. They will still penalize you, but not greatly. But if you are a law enforcer, an agent, and you committed crime, your penalty will be severe for you to have undertaken that crime scene or be part of that. And you will be penalized heavily. But when I hear some comrade saying, oh, we can't do anything, this is not within the Okay, what is Anayo doing now? Is Anayo not coming, stating categorically, loud and clear, that what Ushemefo did is treasonable felony? Ushemefo was giving command to Biafrans to go and do protest, saying anything, anyone they kill, document it and bring it for me. I will use it at the appropriate time. Ushemefo have said that thing. He has said that thing on this radio platform many times. And people were killed in at Mbo, even Headbridge and Oji River and so many other places. Even at Iboja, Ushemefo gave that order and they were protesting. Ushemefo was on the air talking. Now Ushemefo has now established platform, another platform, castigating our leader, calling him all sorts of names with Mazi Obidobienu, and you telling me that it's not treasonable felony. How dare you say that? It is a treasonable felony. Ushemefo calling this movement an ESN terrorist organization, that we're terrorizing people. Why even, I don't even believe him, why the governor of Ebonyi State said that Mayeti Ala are killing people. They are terrorist people. IPOB is not a terrorist organization. They are not terrorizing anybody. Even if he's saying it for 2023, he's a dead on departure, not even arrival. It won't arrive. As he's departing, that idea is dead on departure. So what are they talking about? But this man said it, the governor of Ebonyi State said it, that IPOB, that we don't do harm. If somebody is carrying flag, tell me why that person is a terrorist. The person carrying AK-47 is walking around and they're telling him that he's an evangelical outreach they are going, that they're not terrorists, that AK-47 is Bible and Quran at the same time. Can you believe that? So that is what Ushemefo has been saying with the teams that he set up, even till last night when they were talking. Because whom again will be listening? And he's stating some certain things that are, many things that are not accurate. If Ushemefo could today be calling our leader, you all sort of names, blackmail, I want to tell Biafran this. Ushemefo, yes, he may have been contacted by the secret service of the country where he resides. He may have been paid by the Zulu government to do some certain things. Or he may have been contacted by his half-brother, who is Lawmefo, who is working with the Zulu government all along. Ushemefo never disclosed that to Biafrans. But Ushemefo is now running his mouth like a mad woman, talking all sorts of things that are not accurate. And Mazi Anayo is a very close person, closer to Ushemefo than so many of us. We are not from his town. He came up and distanced himself from that man and said, if I get that man, I will be the first person to strike him. A lot of people have that notion, have that thing. Some may have not said it because of the place where they are residing, but so many of us have that belief system that this man will never step his foot in Biafran land as long as I live. Because it's not appropriate. No one has ever done it and lived. You can't send people to go and protest for their right, and they were shot at and they were killed. All of a sudden you run out and say, this is not, and even saying that we are promoting violence. Are we in the northern place killing their people, raping their women? No, the Fulanis are in our region, raping our women, killing our people, destroying our farm produce, and destroying our, you know, the thing that, you know, give us livelihood, our farms, destroying our businesses. Even in the north, if you set up a business, they will burn it down and tell you, oh, this is a Sharia country or a Sharia state. You are not allowed to conduct anything like hotel, nightclub, breweries. But when the one in the south, southeast or southwest, they will have those things and make business out of it, pay tax, and that tax, Fulanis will take it and saying they are majority in number, that they are not an ass. That revenue that comes from those businesses, Fulani will share it, but they won't want that business to be in the north. Tell me why you should believe that Nigeria should not divide. Tell me why you should believe in that Nigeria. Where the treatment is not equal. Categorically, it's not equal. Ushemefo never spend 1 minute to go for Nigerian and the Nigerian terrorist government. Ushemefo will never use his time to go for Nigerian terrorist movement activities. He will never use his time to look to draw people's attention to that fraudulent constitution. Ushemefo will not do that. Ushemefo will get calls from different quarters and different people that he programmed, paid for, to come on air and be talking while he's sleeping, snoring at the end. And he muted his microphone. And Ushemefo, his main aim is to do what he was paid for to do. What I can tell Biafran is this. Before your enemy will kill you, your enemy will destroy your partnership. If you are in partnership with somebody, negative things about our leader, people will now back off. But it will never happen, because the word of God said, for you shall know the truth, and the truth you know shall set you free. We have known the truth, and that truth has set us free. We are free from bondage, from lies, from deception. This, I am just saying, this is one of the pestle analysis you should apply to be able to figure out who is Ushemefo working for, and who those people behind him, whom they are working for. Ushemefo never believed in the restoration project that after we come. Ushemefo believed that this is our take. He thought our leader is not doing what he thought our leader is Yahoo, like him. So Ushemefo was expecting him to be bringing money so that they will be sharing. Ushemefo didn't know that ESN, Eastern Security Network, is on the way. I have had many people who called me, because when Obidi Obianu was spreading this negative news in America, before even this thing came on air, before Ushemefo boldly took that courage to step aside, I have received more than 100 calls from America. They asked me, Rabbi, you are the only one I can ask this question and I trust. Tell me, is there any security preparation we have behind? Because all the information that I'm getting says that there is nothing coming. He is just making noise. He is scamming people. Nothing is coming. Americans believe that. That is the reason why when they saw ESN, Americans now came up and started doing donation. All of them believe, most of them believe that there is nothing coming. Somebody, I won't mention his name, woke me up at the middle of the night. He called me and said, one day, Biko, Rabbi Biko, tell me, is there anything put in place? Because this thing that we are hearing, I don't want, if anything happens, our people will be massacred. I don't think there is anything put in place. Before heaven and earth, our leader did not tell me anything. But I strayed our leader in the spirit while he was in jail. That was when I strayed his spirit. And Elohim spoke very loud and clear. Said, this is my servant in whom I am well pleased. Pay attention to whatever he's telling you. Loud and clear. Just like Jesus went to John the Baptist to baptize, and a voice spoke from heaven. That voice is still speaking. If you don't hear that voice, that means you are not in that frequency. You are lost. That's why you couldn't hear. So that voice spoke. And I answered the gentleman that called me. I said to him, watch and see. Our leader told us, wait till 2000 and end of the year, December, you will see something. I said, do you think he was bluffing? Do you think so? He said, for sure. I said, 1,000,000,000%. In fact, I don't even think I want to go and sleep. But because of you, you are a man of reputation. I have on the highest esteem. So I will answer you. There is something on the ground. He said, but why is it that most of the principal officers, well, I know that he was employing Obidi Obianu. This DOS, why are they not aware of it? But you are not a DOS. I said, I don't have to be DOS to know what is going on. If I can crack anything nations are doing, what is this that Elohim will not tell me? That was what I told this man. I said, Onyisi, go and relax. At the appropriate time you will sleep, go and sleep. There is something happening. You will see it, and when you see it, you'll be proud. Didn't our leader unveil ESN? And what did you hear Obi the Obiano and Uchebepo say? Uchebepo said initially that he's not aware of all this. Our leader said there are things he knows that Uchebepo, even Uchebepo doesn't know. But it's our leader that made him his deputy. It is our leader who made him his deputy. And we respected that and honored that. But when this man could not believe in what our leader, you know, in our leader's agenda and the vision, it's God that gave our leader the vision, not two people. He gave one person the vision. He called him, he said, go for this assignment. Now he's sharing some of the information. Now say, bring the money, increase the money. Why are you having what paid? You are being paid a lot of money. Everything about them is money. Why they are coming up is to see if they can get gullible beer fans so that they can be paying them. And if you listen to this man and give them a dime, you're a fool. I have had even someone of a high esteem in this movement called me. That was when I knew that something is wrong with this man. He said, there is nothing happening. Let him set a kind of government. But because he doesn't have, it's like he's moving around like a tourist. He said it clearly to me. And I, not our leader hasn't even, he doesn't even know me. He talk less of making me his emissary. But I was acting as emissary, as a diplomat. I was representing him accurately. I said, no, sir. If this thing is not true, I wouldn't have put my dime in it. If this man is not genuine, I wouldn't have stepped out and for people to see my face. This is true. I will never hide when I'm fighting for Biafra. The enemies that are ripping us off are the ones that should be in hiding, not me. I've not seen a criminal come. It is criminal that should cover their faces, not the owner of the house. So these Western powers are coming in our place and making us through the Fulanese with their British counterpart, the Dutch. And I'm the one hiding instead of them to run. They will run. And we will shake them, they will run. So what are we talking about? Uchemefo is a man that, oh God, he lost, he doesn't have vision. Visionless man. Very heartless and wicked. That is Uchemefo. Uchemefo is out of touch. Even when I met him on one-on-one, close range, which is counterpart those ones running around with him. Very heartless people. Tell me if you are legalized and you don't want your fellow brothers and sisters to be legalized. Tell me about that. I love what Emeka Gift wrote. I read what Emeka Gift wrote. If you haven't read it, go to his homepage and read that thing that man wrote about Uchemefo. Uchemefo thinks that he will use the blood of Pierre France to practice his human rights lawyer that IPOB, our contribution, paid for. One like ever got plan of practice here. Where will he be to practice that thing? Obuho obose aburo sisi ko na wu. Obuho obose akwaturo sisi ko sisi na wu. He doesn't think about our people. That is why I will always recommend Anayo for standing up. We love people like that. If you are my brother, if you are my five and six, and you engage into some certain fraudulent activities, or insubordination, or a wicked act in this movement, before heaven and earth, if it gets to my notice, I will go for you. Regardless of whatever you may think you are, I will go for you. Sooner or later, I will track you down. A lot of people are talking, oh yeah, listen, if you are in my position, you will do damages to people. People that have power don't talk. There was a day we were in Trafalgar Square. I came there to supervise our people. I was badged. I don't wear badge publicly. My badge stays inside. And I had a team of law enforcement agents around. So I was greeting one of our brothers who saw me. So our body language, because they were watching me, So they thought maybe that guy was resisting my instructions. So they came immediately to apprehend the brother. So I said, this police white guy, you know, they said, what's going on? Is he? I said, no. We are actually, he was excited. He's excited to see me. And I'm excited to see him because we lost contact for a long time. So the man said, oh, okay. Then that was when that brother saw that man moving back to his position. He saw where they crowded. And he said, are you with us? I said, of course. You think they are not around? So I don't wear uniform. But I put my profession, my badge at stake for this. So if I die on the process, you think I will regret? I didn't die young. So this man, whomever that may have contacted this idiot, and he started talking, hear what this man, Ushemefo, all these men, hear what they are saying. You will know that these guys are paid by a Nigerian agent to do this nonsense. I will apologize to South African because I always use our people to say, our people can do this. So my people can do this. I will apologize. I will write the apology letter to them because back in the days I was selling, I never knew that this bunch of idiots can be bought with a morsel of bread. What can they pay you for your freedom? To jettison your freedom, to abandon your freedom, and that of others. What can they give you for you to start talking rubbish? If you tell me to step down, I will go and step down and sleep. It is holiday for me. Our leader always say, Ufabara will leave to Kenya. If you kick a toad or frog, you give it a lift because he's always hopping, jumping. And I love the Dutch name for frog. They call it kicker. Kicker. So if you kick it, you get the kicker lift. So our leader sacrificed greatly and still sacrificing. Is Ushemefo's mother and father, did they die as a result of freedom fighting? I heard our leader saying, I hate the black people. He's a black man, remember. I am also a black person. We all Africans were black. He said, I hate. Not that he hate them as he hate them as being wicked and unreasonable. That is what he meant. Look at the policy, look at the Yoruba media. They don't even recognize that this man was shot in his house. They shot at him in his house and killed 28 people, including his pet. Jack killed everything there, and he narrowly escaped death. And some people are saying, where did you run to? You are runaway soldier. These are bunch of wicked souls and heartless human beings. Luciferians, I call them. Luciferians. People without compassion. People whose conscience are seared with hot iron. They're dead, walking. And I am associating, if I had known that this Ushemefo, because I know already, but not too early when he started, I would have taken that idiot out. I will never wait. I will, if I pass the message to our leader and he doesn't want to pay attention, I will let them do the job. Animal he is. And he's telling people, standing in his comfort zone, in that place where he is residing, talking about the movement, IPOB, do this, IPOB, bullying people, Eastern Security, that terrorists of me, the generation. You will never come back. You will never reincarnate, Ushemefo, you won't. You are nobody, but I just want to assure anybody listening that you are nothing. IPOB made you. Not that you have acquired every status before you came to the movement. The movement gave you status. You were statusless. You were statusless. You don't have any status. It is the movement that gave you status. The blood of Biafrans gave you status. You got it and you turned your back against Biafrans. You think Mazi, our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, will not speak about you. It is.
Are you still there, Mazi?
Combine them together. Obi Dogbe Yelu was indicted before for fraud, embezzling, and not letting people that know what to do come up to do the job. He always demoralizing people, talking down on people, and doing all sorts of negative things. Even when I came to show my offering, Obido Bienu almost talked me off. I said, you should have prayed for me that I am here to sow this seed. So what is it for? Not everybody got that kind of money. Don't expect everybody to pay that money. Imagine that. I quickly stopped the one that used to go on direct debit, and after that one I gave, I didn't give to that platform anymore. I am talking from personal encounter. I think it was before the atonement, a week before then, I gave that 1,000, I think 1 pound or so. That is what this man that should have prayed for me said. I said, Eme, I don't see your seat existing. And he has been doing it to many people. What about Onyibe? The dog that is talking, Bingo, that is talking. If they give him a little thing, he's jumping up and down and talking, thinking he has people. Onyibe, Omugerigi. You can't bite the finger that fed you. He said, it's a sin against Elohim. Different fingers all over the world, we are all for you, supporting you, paying you, giving you whatever. But you lost vision, you don't have vision. You don't know what you are talking about. You will get on the platform. What you will descend is on the Yorubas. Yoruba did you this, Yoruba did you that. And you have Yoruba people too, because they don't know your face. Because you will talk about them. You know, as we, their friends and the Yorubas or Duduwas have connected for a very long time. We've been good neighbors. We Yorubas and their friends have been doing business. Even those that haven't come to this platform, this family, IPOB, they have been doing business. And no issues. They have been building Yorubas or Moniles if they have Igbo agents that is connecting them to Igbo rich men. They will be eating. You can't severe them. You can't celebrate us. Moniles live on the Igbos to connect them to people with money to buy properties in Lagos and even Ogun State. Sometimes area of Ikorodu. They are there. That's their business. Igbos and Yorubas. And this man will begin to lash them. Yoruba did what Igbos did, some certain things too. Even to Ayo Eta. To tell about people, can we talk? So it's not only for the idiot from Benue State saying we Igbos play always victim. We are not playing any victim. We are telling it the way it is. So Mazi Onyibe, who has been living on Biafran's sweat, even mine, I was sending money to him. Our leader doesn't know about it. It was from my benevolency, out of my benevolent heart, my heart. I was giving that man money until Elohim spoke to me and said, that man is evil. Onyibe is evil. He's an evil man. A wicked man. Look at how he is, how he looks like. Even every appearance of Mazi Onyibe states satanic. Satanic indeed. He said, who is blackmailing who? I don't have time to black. Anything I tell you is what I'm doing. I have to, I'm not. Not only me, many other people in America, they were giving you money. You thought you've gotten them. You've gotten us. Shame on you. You will pay heavily for what you have sold. For the word of God states that God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he shall reap. You will reap what you sowed. Mazi Anayo, I commend you for your stand. For you, look at, you know, the barriers. Look at things you should have looked into, but you didn't look at them. Looking at from the area of being from the same place, you didn't look at it. Looking at from the area of being the same Anambra as they think. Biafran agitation restoration has nothing to do with Anambra anymore. We didn't shoot that Anambra. We were East Central States. We were Biafrans before we joined amalgamated to become part of Nigeria. We were never Anambra, Imo, Ebonyi. These are the things they created while you are even a grown man or woman. And you are doing what? So what I can say this, what I can say to them is this, that the evil they sow, we hunt them. If you think the security network is your nightmare, that will remain your nightmare, because you now feel, oh, these security men are everywhere. I can never go back home. That's what they're thinking. That they can never go back home. So let them do what? The one idiot called from Canada. Talking. What are you doing in Canada? If you are a man enough, find yourself, locate yourself in Biafraland. Our leader located himself in he said, I will be there. He said he broadcasted from the zoo, and the zoo couldn't do anything. He was in at the airport. He was broadcasting or talking to people about the evil of Nigeria at the airport. He was in the court, told the people there, tell Buhari that he's a madman. And Ushemefo is in London sleeping and snoring. Now he's talking. And he's gonna get some certain folks in Biafra land. You think you follow Ushemefo because he's your Anambra brother or Idemili brother? He's gonna save you. You are an idiot. That man can let. He can't step out of United Kingdom. He can't get out. Where will he go? Where will he go? People that are men are talking. Ushemefo is talking. One now, Mazolo, ask me anything in Dewo.
Mazi, thank you very much. Get it, but I'm back. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. All right. No, Maz, you've said so many things. So many things you've said. That is what this show is all about. All right, Mazi, I want us to discuss a little bit about the ESN. But before we do that, I know our time is fast going, but I also want us to discuss a little bit about our leader. You know, our leader has gone through so many things. You know, it's just like we reading the Bible today. You know, the story of your Yeshua is just, you know, when you read it in the Bible, it seems so simple. You know, story of about 5 to 10 years, you will read it in just some 2-3 paragraph and you think that is it. Our leader has gone through so many things. I remember when our leader was telling us about what he went through, and one of our sisters also made mention on that on Radio Biafra, I think on my name sake Obilo and Tony's program this morning. He said he remember what our leader passed through when he went to marry. I don't know if you can touch a little bit on that. The women, they urinate and pour it on our leader. Not just that they naked our leader, and the women urinate and pour it on him. What kind of humiliation is that? Yet he is still moving forward. Not just that. Nigerian government alone is hunting him. Even those that are his own people is hunting him, trying to kill him. Now you have this one, the one you call Ababo.
Ababo.
Fronting himself with Radio Human Rights is also hunting our leader. Please, can you go a little bit further on this story that I do, you know, can you go a little bit further about it before we?
There is a saying in Igbo language, one if a little canary, the baby, the new hatched canary, is still in the mother's nest, that nest was built by the mother laid the egg that hatched that canary out. He hasn't grown wings yet. He said that his mother doesn't know how to fly. That is Ushemefo. What can anyone listening to this moron, what can he say that this man will take him to? Where can they say that Ushemefo will take them to? With the way Ushemefo, the level of his understanding, the scope of his knowledge. The versatility of Ushemefor's mindset is not a versatile man. What can Ushemefor offer? You went and studied right law. There are many people with PhD degrees, even in law. They're not talking. They're relaxed. Some of them doesn't have the temerity, the boldness to speak. Our leader from nowhere began to speak like what Yeshua did, Yeshua HaMashiach did. He came to the temple where they were having people to come to do sacrifice. Why our leader, why Yeshua turned the temple upside down? You know what? The corruption that was in the temple was so heavy. He came there, he saw the Pharisees and the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the Sanhedrin, the high priest, they projected some certain people who will be there exchanging money and, you know, giving them animal for sacrifice. So when you bring animal without blemish, you have to come with animal without blemish for your sacrifice or atonement. So when you come there, these people will locate one thing in that animal and tell you that the one you came with is not good. That you have to buy the one they are having. The thing became business too. And the people will now go back, abandon the animal they came with. They will take it back and buy the one the high priest and these Pharisees and Sanhedrin were selling to them, and they will sell it double the price, just to extort money from them. So this thing came to Elohim. Elohim sent his son there. When he got there, he kicked the table upside down, the table of money changers, and went to the place where the cage, where they put the doves, and let the dove fly off, and then all of them flew away. If you bring your dove, they will say your dove is spotted. He has a working hip at your home. It doesn't work properly. In fact, this dove is not qualified for this. Buy this one. That's what they were doing. Haji, the Church of God, Abambere. That is what Ushemefor, Mazo Nibe. I had our brother Jonathan Chinedu yesterday, last night, saying Onyibe was collecting money for even his comrades to come on air to talk. He will collect money from them. What a wicked man. And this Jonathan Chinedu, our brother, was confirming it with every authenticity. He wasn't lying, because I had it already. I had it as well. And these are the type of people that Yeshua saw and kicked them out from the temple. Say, don't use my father's house as a place of merchandise. Don't use IPOB, Biafran Agitation Restoration, as a place of merchandise. That is what we are doing here. Some people are using it as a place of merchandise where they do transaction. They are always on the air. And when you listen to them, you think these guys are freedom fighters. Put him in business, he will double cross you. He's not a freedom fighter. And you are telling me not to talk. Amubegia. If you have the vision and see what is at stake, you will never let any opportunity slip out of your hands. When our leader came to do wedding, Wazurike and his men caught him, humiliated him. Women urinated at him. What does that mean? To break you. When that thing is done to you, you will feel that you are not man enough. It will leave stigma in mind. You can't be bold or bodacious and audacious to speak. Look at our leader. Is he not bodacious and audacious when he's talking? I love what our beloved friend, the journalist Dele Momundu, said about him. He said that man is talk and do man. That man and this ESN are very disciplined people. That is why there are so many encounters. I got the update. First, second, third, and fourth encounter with ESN, Nigerian military ran off. They couldn't withstand them. They come with speed of lightning. They are very quick. They are very quick in action. Nigerian Boko Haram terrorist army ran off. Oh, the almighty army that always come Python Dance 1, Python Dance 2. They can't go to Sambisa to fight. Only at the Eastern Region to fight. To go and humiliate people. And one lied down like a masked man shooting somebody on a range, on a stage. And shot a woman, opened the score with AK-47. Ushemefo and the rest will not see it. All they want to say, Mazina and the Kano is bringing war because they are paid to be saying that. They are Nigerian agents. If you hear them saying, like after that, they will say, I hate Nigeria so much, I never like, it is a lie. An agent will never tell you that, I love that the Nigeria. If they are Nigerian agent, they won't tell you openly, verbally, that they love Nigeria. They will tell you they hate Nigeria, they don't fall in. But when you extract their activities, their alterations, what they are saying, their comments, that is what will make you to understand that these guys are working for Nigeria. In as much as that, they are blaming IPOB, saying, he's working for politicians, he's collecting money from the politicians, they are giving him money, and this is what they are, the blackmail they are coming up with. So Wazirike did it. Do you think that Wazirike will be at peace to watch Biafra to come under Mazen Nnamdi Kanu? Wazirike, if he's a smart guy, he will go for exile. And they are saying, there are things they are saying, why can't he go and attack all these politicians? Why are they going to Ogunike? Why are they attacking? Why can't they go and attack, what is his name? Onyesonwike. Why can't they do anything? Obienu. Let me tell you something.
Obi Nkita.
Obi Aturuman Nkita. Anything. Let me tell you something. You don't write agenda for IPOB. The person doing the command and control with giving directives is Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. He knows when to tell them to stand up, they will stand. When to sit, they will sit. When to move, they will move. It is not you. So you cannot tell our leader or the Biafrans what to do. Because you lack the vision, you don't have it. You never have it, talk less of lacking it. This thing is what they always tell me in those days. There are some certain guys that when I meet them, their size will scare me and they will be, doing all sorts of things to me. One day, and my mom said to me, there's a guy that always bully me around. And my mom got angry and took me to bitter leaf tree that stem. We bitter leaf plantation where we planted bitter leaf in our place and pull one stem and use it on me, wipe me bitterly. Said, do you know that you are a few months older than that guy? I said, but what buribu? My mom asked him, "Obu ngbo ngbo na wa me buna." Obu ngbo gonna go be the Obi Enu on a man wear my short mind. If you see him, he look like Goliath. Goliath. Appearance, but he has a heart of ant. It's not a man. He is talking when we hear, listen, these people, I don't know what to do to our people. Sometimes I feel like I am Yeshua HaMashiach wearing Pirampira. Can you understand the Nisi? Some of us, we are very gullible that somebody will call you from overseas, you think he has arrived. So India na abogi, say, do this for me. You are in Africa, in overseas. Tell him to shut up. Overseas, you are in overseas, doesn't give you what it takes. It is the level where you are. And if you are at level, you will not be calling people in Africa to do this and do that. Obidobienu issues orders also. Look at Ushemefo here. Amokwame ba ogane enyu Ushemefo aduro. I know when he's eating, chopping aduro. Under IPOB. Today, because, this man, all these men, I don't think, our leader may forgive them all, but me, my heart, I know where I put them. Dikane, we honor me. I know where I put them. plus those ones that are still in IPOB doing the same rubbish. I know them. You think they like that I'm on air talking? I know them. I know them. Our leader didn't tell me anything to come and do damage control. I came naturally. You know that you didn't send a message last night to me. Not at all. You never posted anything to me. Look at what I'm going to ask you. Not at all.
No.
Yes, but you never did that. But it is something that is born in you. What is in you? When I finished that last time, I had a brother coming. Oh, I am praying for Rabbi, nothing for him not to fall. Hey, Chidekeda. Mazi, I love you so much. I love your prayers. Pray for others. My life is in Biafra hand in this restoration. I didn't see IPOB when I sued a country in Europe. I took them to International Court of Human Rights. That country gave me their citizenship. But I still sue them for evil that they are doing. I told them, if you want to take the citizenship, go ahead and do it. I'm using African country nationality. I will go and remain there. If God's, what gives you money is not the red passport. You can have the red passport if your country's own is red. America's own, I think, is blue. The African's own is green. They gave us green because it's a jungle. Green leaves, green tree. And Europeans are using... Europeans are using red. The color of their passport is red. Chinese is red. They gave Africa. South Africa used to be blue. When ANC took over, it became blue. It became green. And the other countries, European Union is red. For the fact that you have it, we never put food on your table. All it gives you is security and sense of belonging, free movement. But to become anything has to do with your mind, what you have upstairs. I know many people that have it, they are broke. And people that have it, they are in debt. They don't even know how to walk out of it. So what are we talking about here? So this is what this man is having, and he jumped inside forest. Our leader used to say one language, Obonye Ononto. A hungry man cannot do freedom fighting. If you can't stand on your own and feed yourself and your family, you cannot do freedom fighting, because if they offer you flash anything that costs currency, you will fall. So if they couldn't break our leader by urinating on him, beating him up, tying him, and giving him all kind of assault, he's still up and is still standing and talking. There is a day for payment, and all of them will get their salary. Mazi, our people, let me correct what I said, or paraphrase on what I said. I called somebody about because of his structure. I am maybe probably bigger than him, or different on different ways. I'm muscular in my own structure, okay? And it's not by his physical appearance. I am talking of his sanity. Ababu doesn't move. If you keep Ababu here, it will not move. It will remain there. That's what I mean. Ushemefo can't move. Our leader can move. Our leader is flexible in mind. Our leader can engage you for as long as, for the next century, he will engage you in discussion. You will wear off. Our leader will be standing. Our leader doesn't sleep on a program. People will say, Abokwari Ababu, Ushemefo is spiritually Ababu Komo, or Abaja. Because we have to look at things. Because a simple-minded person will say, he will go so, because he said, because he's huge. No! Hugeness is the man. Me marry here. Hugeness is the man. Even at the end, be me pota. Me marry here. Obugi, either dimba. Our people, my mom always say, na madu buri bu kop up guru na nego. The old kobo, if you see that penny, it is bigger than even 50 pence, 50 kobo. In the that time, it was in coins. If you see one penny even in England, it's bigger than 20 penny. But that kobo that is big cannot get you anything of significance, anything tangible. It can't even give you a can of Coca-Cola. But it's huge. That is exactly what I'm saying. Some people are wired like to be elephant, but in their mind they are rabbit. You see, there is one thing, this bird that I talked about the other day, Oboko. Oboko is a bird. A lot of people, we always say, Oboko burunti chiria. Oboko is a bird that is wired to fly. But Oboko cannot fly properly. This Elohim has ways of creating. He created these things for us to use it to express ourselves. If somebody call you also, that means you don't belong to the flying birds and you don't belong to the crawling animals. Because if you go to the flying birds, they will say, what are you doing here? I can see teeth in your mouth. Then if it goes to the one that is crawling, they will say, what are you doing with wings here? So Usu is bat. It doesn't belong to the flying birds in the air, and it doesn't belong to the crawling animals on the ground. So somebody can be spiritual Usu by his behavior. He's a bat. He doesn't belong anywhere. And Usu only sees clearer at night. These guys operate in the dark. They don't come to the public as our leader does come to the public. They walk in the dark. That is, God gave us these things in order for us to use it to express ourselves. So I am not telling him because it's huge by structure. After all, Obidio Bienu is bigger than Mazu Shemefo. The centen and tempest. So you just get huge, that you will use your size to do significant achievement. When they needed people of heavy high duty structure to come out, you will be hiding. Everywhere you gonna toughness. Or Ashobazi Obidi Afugia. Chabazu Shemefa Fugia. Chaba Dimba Nkena Bambana Radio. Mazu Onibe. Afugia. Ohani Nebara voicemail. Now operating the dark. That is what I'm trying to say. Now coming to what you are saying about the ESN and our leader not telling them, and how long will this thing take to take our leader to achieve? Let me tell us something. When God told Moses, or when God said in his prophetic declaration about the state of Israel, he said they will be in the land of Egypt for 4 days. That is what their treasury will put them into. What the act of the sons of Jacob did to Joseph brought them down there. And he said 400 years they will be in that slavery. But do you know that Moses was visited by God? He gave him that heart to deliver them at the age of at the period of 390 years. 10 years to 400 years was when this thing, the restoration, came into place. But the people did not understand. God actually minus 10 years of suffering from them. Do you know? Because I have dealt with this before. And let me do it again in a different place. God, what God intended to do was to allow the present Pharaoh as at that time to die. If that present Pharaoh had died, Moses would have been the Pharaoh of Egypt. And Moses could have, while he's in that position, he knew that he was a Hebrew man. He knew, though he speaks Egyptian language, he dresses like them, he acts like them, he doesn't live in Goshen. He lives in the place where they were living. Who knows? It could be Cairo. It could be Alexandria. I don't know where the position is today, but it is the same. Now, Moses could have rose up as a Pharaoh and said, from today, I will abolish this thing. Let these people go. I don't want them to be here. So when he has discharged them at night, Moses will flee and run away. You see, and the council of heaven gathered together, and they said, this thing is an act of cowardice. Let me tell you, this is deep. The council of heaven gathered together and said, this is like escape. Why are you the God of wonders? Where are these your wonderful or wondrous acts that you possess? You know, this God is a being that you can challenge. If you go, I come from a royal family. When you come to the palace of a king, you don't talk to him. King, I don't know if you are credible enough or capable enough to do this. If you come to the palace of my grandfather, you say, I'm a minzuru keme. Opodu anabu yodu. Inabu yodu while he's eating. Ona anuya. Opwekwe anakwekwe. Zuzube, zuzube, anakuriyekwe. Situation or I'm here and that situation. Where is that thing? That is a king. That's how God behaves. So the council of God began to talk to Elohim. He said, if you do this way, the history book, they said you are not capable to perform wonders and you just deceive them to escape. Remember, he said to Moses, tell Pharaoh you are going to 3 days worship. That you are not going to, you are just going for 3 days. While the council of God was in the heaven talking, they even came again and told him, if they do this thing now, this is escape. This is coward escape. And God said, is that so? Then he said, they said yes. The council of heaven said yes. Not alone. You see, this thing you don't see it in your scripture. I will bring it to what we are doing now. They said yes. Why are you the God of wonders? Where are those wonderful acts? You actually created this world by spoken words. You said, let there be light, light. Let this, let that happen. And Elohim said, is that so? He said, yeah. He said, now I will harden the heart of Pharaoh to say no. Read it in your scriptures. He said, I will harden his heart to disobey the order. And he said to Moses, go and tell Pharaoh you are going for 3 days sacrifice. And Pharaoh said to him, you can go with your this, with your that, but leave the animals behind. And don't go very far away. Go where I will be seeing you. Moses came back. God got what he's looking for. And Moses said to Elohim, look at what the cabinet are saying. Look at what Pharaoh is saying. And Elohim said, I will come go to the river Nile in the morning. Who comes there to bath? Just touch that rod there and you will see what will happen. I have commanded you. And Moses departed from his presence. The 10th plague completely occurred. Remember, look at what our leader said. People don't catch what he's saying prophetically. He said, they killed 5 million above Biafrans. He said, I would not let this thing go like that until those people that killed our people, cause people that the number will total to above 5 million. Watch out. Makata Boshata. I don't want to speak in tongues. I'm holding myself. I don't want to speak in tongues. That means a kind of extension has been added. it is God that is hardening the heart of the zoo, the handlers of the zoo, be them from the British section or from the Fulanese. It is Elohim that is hardening them in order to do his wonders. Get the message. I did not have consultation with our leader, Onyendu, but I can see in the spirit. He said it. He said, you know what? The killings, the massacrings, the destructions, we get to 5 million people and above. Then I will now say I am done with all this because they killed a lot of people. And you see what is going on there. There are those that we don't record going on in the north. Killings going on there. All of them participated in the killing of their friends. I am not happy with them over there. They are normally, naturally, they should be our brothers and our sisters. But because they apply this hatred, they endorse it with this ethnic cleansing, they endorse this genocidal activities, the killing of the Piafran, just like anti-Semitism, the massacring of the Jews, the taking of the Jews to gas chambers and assassinated them there and killed them. Elohim said, I will remember their iniquities and punish them. I will punish them for killing. Yes, I put them in that place, but they killed them. I will remember it and I will punish them. Our leader, when things begin to take place, go and consult heaven. There is a consultation going on there above. That was when Elohim began to extend. And the children of Israel, actually, when Moses came wanting to deliver them, they triggered a kind of information to Pharaoh. And Moses ran to the land of Midian. But that was 390 years. God wanted to give them 10 years a grace to wait it, to take 10 years, shorten the time, to give them 390 years as a result of grace. But the children of Israel, because they lack the timing, they lack the understanding, they lack the knowledge of the days of their visitation, now they now made Moses to run. Because they went and told Pharaoh. The saboteurs went and sang to the ears of Pharaoh. Do you know that Moses is not even an Egyptian? This Moses, you see, is not, he killed one Egyptian, buried him in the sand. And he told us not to speak. If you can reduce this level, or if you can give me contract, then I will be telling you, giving you more information. And Pharaoh said, well done. And now went and increased their suffering. These saboteurs talking for the sabotaging this effort. All of them have families in Biafra. All of them, the Fulanese doesn't know who is who. When they come there, they can kill any members of their family unless they walk their families out of that zoo. You see, but they don't know because they are very foolish and they are blind. They are very stupid. They are just tighter. They don't understand the season and the timing. So they don't know. What they are doing is, let me eat it and die here. Why they are suffering? So instead of them to come closer and team up with our people and said, what can we do? This is amazing. This has now put fear in the eyes of the Fulanese. They cannot come and kill us like animals, like chicken. They cannot have their ways anymore. And we can support this. We can even partner with you. We will put money and we support this thing. Let fear. But you cannot use ESN to go and negotiate for 2023 Igbo presidency. You can't do that. Our people can't die for that. This thing, our leader gave very, look, you have sea everywhere in Biafran land. There is no seaport in Igbocha. There is no seaport in Warri. There is no seaport even in Kaba. There is no seaport in Niger or Nishadia. That thing can be drained and it will be converted to a viable seaport. They have the knowledge that we can do it, but they cannot. And you don't have airport in all these places that I mentioned that the people from that area travel the most. They cannot do that. So now they are now telling you to 2023, you are a fool to believe them. Even Igbo man, if my papa is there, that he wants to become a Nigerian president, I swear before heaven, I will take a trip and gun him down. If he insists, I will say, okay, dad, no problem. I will go and get a very good 9mm. At night, I will take him down. I will escape. I will do it. Because that is how I feel now. So you cannot understand that your people are suffering. You want to say 2023, on which constitution? Do you know that Buhari has died 2017? Buhari is late, he's not alive. Aisha Buhari is in Dubai, living there. Which president can do, which president, president's wife can do that? At least President Cyril Ramaphosa is with the wife in South Africa. Other presidents are living with them. You can go overseas, maybe you want to take a trip, as they always do. But they live together. And you are telling yourself that Buhari is alive, when every indication is indicating that Buhari has died. 2017, and these Fulanis are keeping it. You are not ashamed. None of you are ashamed. All the judiciaries there are not ashamed. All the lawmakers, enforcement agency, you are not ashamed. Who is giving you the command to do destruction? Who are those giving you command? They said, Office of the Presidency. Have you heard of that before? And when anything happens, the president will not come publicly to address the issue as other prime ministers are doing. Boris Johnson is doing it. Anything, even COVID, he's always on TV. All of them, you can see him talking. And these ones, you can see Mark Rutte of the Netherlands, you see him talking. You can see Emmanuel Macron of France, you can see him talking. Angela Merkel, you can see her in Germany talking. But where is your president and the wife? And Nigerians, you can't reason. So they are giving our leader, this is the time. I will tell you something. The children of Israel spent 430 years. Moses spent from 398, Moses left and spent 40 years in the land of Midian. At the 40th year, when Elohim appeared to Moses in burning bush and sent him back. Moses had encounter with Pharaoh, heavy encounter. Do you know that Pharaoh actually wanted to assassinate Moses, but he couldn't? When he gets to that place, the wonders will appear. They will run back. Do you know that he has used his magician to pin Moses through their enchantment and incantation? And they couldn't. When they invoke the spirit will stand up and tell them, and tell the magicians, I see a pillar of fire around that man. And they will run back. Do you know that? Because you never have it in your scripture, it is there. Pharaoh attempted to assassinate Moses, as Nigeria attempted to assassinate Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. You saw it on that fateful day, on the 14th of September 2017. We all saw it. And you want to sweep it under the carpet, Yoruba journalist? This is the thing. So our leader and Elohim and the Council of Heaven are having consultation. Obi Jobienu will tell you, which Council of Heaven? If you see dead people talking, I mean dead in the spirit, when you tell them the secret counsel of God, it is foolishness to their understanding. They won't understand. So the Council of Heaven now looked into the level of atrocity committed by Nigeria and the British, and they said, I will punish these people. I'm not satisfied with their things. And our leader, they have promised our leader so many times, okay, if you do this, if you call off this protest, we will do this. When our leader called it off, they will begin to do another thing. Didn't that happen in Egypt? When another plague will come, flies will come, Pharaoh will say, okay, I have repented, you can go. Just this fly to go. Tell it to go where it came from. Moses will come out and raise his hand and the rod and say, oh Lord, suspend this. And the next minute, you will not see them anymore. They will fly off. And Pharaoh will harden his heart, thinking, oh yes, it is a coincidence. And the next time, God will say, command frogs to come. Frog, he will tell Pharaoh, say, it is frog that will come. I am not telling you it's cockroach. It is frog. So when you see frog, you know that I'm the one that did it. This is what he said to Wike. If this thing, when this thing happened to you, don't say it was a coincidence. You know that I am am the one that said it and it happened. Una de gente. Una chen onya hubaka. Onya huna wuno opu. Onyem duna wuno agwa yoku. Una chen that man hubaka. Ya hoji neni kwe ka agwari anye. I don't know. Oh my God. I think I spoke in tongues. I said, "Today, Biafra will come. I will speak in tongues." It came naturally out of my mouth. Biafra is here. I'm telling us that man, Abagaka, Biafrans, that man, Mazin Nam de Kano, Abagaka, Eziriosi, anyway, Eziriosi, Ogezi Shadiosi, accomplish here. Omari Hokuru. Also, in a Biafra Degodi, Niaga continue watching Nigeria poor. Una mi homin. A win of Yamazi, you had it.
Of course.
You had him.
Yeah.
We because, oh my God, if you speak to people that are not connected in the spirit, they won't understand this. Obi this yanya, if what I know 2020 Kogabia. Do you know how many years ANC fought white oppression? Do you know how many years ANC fought that regime? The people that started it, all of them died. And eventually, Mandela was Sisulu, Govan Mbeki, that is the father of Thabo Mbeki, where the last session we saw, we recorded them, I saw them, I know them, I met them alive. I know Water Sisulu, the one with gray hair. I didn't know Steve Biko, he died before I was even born. So something like that, yes. Oliver Tambo, I did not meet him. He's already dead. Before South Africa was liberated. So to say, I didn't meet them. There are those that Govan Mbeki, the father of Thabo Mbeki, knows Steve Biko, knows Oliver Tambo. His generation knows those ones in the past. You saw the man, nobody. I saw Clarence Makweto of PA, Pan-African Congress. He was a member of ANC before the ANC moved out. He moved out and said, "One settler, one bullet." He had that slogan, "One settler, one bullet." And they said, "No, we don't want to use that slogan because of international communities." And ANC doesn't use that word. But PAC used to have that word, "One settler, one Fulani, one bullet." That is what it means. One Fulani, one bullet. And PAC believed it. Can we talk about Bantu Holomisa, UDM, General Bantu Holomisa? I know them. These are the generations that I saw that fought for the liberation of South Africa. Their names are written in the book of life for liberating South Africa. No matter how we see it, at least South Africa was liberated. The young man I sent the picture was the one that after the inauguration, he was on the platform. They said, "You can't stand behind the president," and went to this level, condescended this low, and disgraced us. Go to jail for life. They don't talk about whiter than white and whiter than snow. They practice it. You see, so when you are a principal officer or even coming as a member of IPOB, you appeared in a crime scene. You are into crime activities, fraudulent activities. You are not supposed to be talking on the radio. You should be behind the scene and doing whatever you are doing, asking God to help you. When God liberates you, channel your idea and your finance into something else. That you can be proud to say, "This is what I worked for. This is what I achieved." That is true freedom fighting spirit. So if somebody come to tell you, he gave us a time, that time has elapsed, he's confused. He did that to Moses. Moses at a time went to get communication from Elohim at Mount Sinai. When they got there, and the thing took longer than they expected. They said, this Moses, he has lost his way. He can't lead us. He's gone. Has lost direction. The navigation that he was using is at fault. Now, let us put money to make a golden calf that we deliver us. Look at that. Remember, the gold they are about to use to make that calf was Elohim that told them to go and ask. When at the final encounter, Elohim made it look impossible to show you that this is not ordinary thing. For those who are asking, it wasn't ordinary. He said, go while in the midst of these killings, in the midst of death, in the midst of plague, go and ask them to give you articles of gold, articles of silver, even diamond. Anything that you can ask them now, they will give it to you. Now, everyone went to different homes. I said, imagine somebody conducting funeral, and somebody comes to him and said to the family, please, we want you to give us your gold and silver. And they'll say, wait a minute, Abiba. Instead of them to go and carry AK-47 or arrow, they will come out with boxes of jewelries and give it to you. Say, take, please, these are all that I have now. You can take it and go. Elohim now, show them that this, he said, with God, all things are possible. For with him, I am with you people, all things are possible. Now go. Now they went and carried it. This is the same article that gave them that the evil one deceived them. Say, bring it out. Bring it out. And let us mold the golden calf. That is what Obi Ijeopienu and Ushemefor is trying to do to you people. Bring your money. If the money that I have now is Elohim that deposited that money into your hand for such a time as this. To support Mazin Nnamdi Kanu and IPOB in whatever he says you want to do. He may not give you the business plan as Obi Ijeopienu is asking him. Give us the roadmap. Give us the business plan. You think this is democracy?